Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In the last 2 months, I've been sharing my design with Detour posts with mockups on there. So one of the questions I get a lot is, how do I get these mockups with people wearing my shirts or with the designs with the shirts on the side? I'm gonna show you how I do these, and it's all with Placeit. So we're gonna go in Placeit right now. I'm gonna show you my tips and tricks there, how it works, what you can do for free, the prices, and basically everything to do with mockups. Now they do a lot more things than mockups, but this video will be focused on mockups and how you can make these mockups super easy and use them for social media. And I'll show you how I use them for social media on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. So let's go to Placeit right now and I'll show you everything you need to know. All right, so here we are on placeit.net. You can see right there. And I'm just gonna talk about the homepage for a little bit. You can see they have a lot more than mockups. So mockups is their first thing, their main thing, but you can do designs. They have design templates. It can show you logos as well. They do videos. I have a video for that. Gaming, which shows you some gaming ideas for t-shirts and logos. If we click on here, you can see merch and streaming and all those different things for maybe people who do more gaming content and learn. So they have a blog and designs and how to do these things. So really cool tools here if you're in on the print on demand space or selling any of these things. Pricing right here, I'll just go right into it. I'm not logged in right now. I do have an account, and you may want to know what the price is for that. And it is $9.99 a month, about $10 a month. And you get all these things, like I said. Or you can start with a free account, and I'll show you what that is. If you do free account, you're going to have to sign in with your email and password. And I'll show you some things that you can actually do for free. But let's go back to the homepage. And they update this a lot. So you can see St. Patrick's Day is coming up. They have all these mockups already there, designs as well, Women's Day videos and so on. So visit this regularly, you'll see the changes. They add new templates all the time too. So you can see there, and just lots of cool stuff, right? So again, $9.99, and you can browse through here for all the different things. There's lots of great content on here, and for free. A lot of things are for free. So let's go here, let's just go mockup. You can see there's outfit mockups, which are trending garment, but we're gonna go print on demand, and we're gonna go t-shirts. Now you can see right here, these are some of the mockups that I've used that you might have seen, and you can put it on here. They have mockups with people, they have mockups with two people, they have mockups with just t-shirts or a group of people. I usually like using the ones with just people, and you can see right away what it would look like with the t-shirt on it or a design on the t-shirt, and it's super easy to use. Now, to find the free ones, it will say free across here, and you can just type in free. And you can see free t-shirt mockups like that. And these are absolutely free with your free account after you sign in. You can use any of these and put your design on it. So it works exactly the same way as if you had an account already. So I'm gonna sign in. You don't have to, you can still follow along with one of these free ones on here, and it will work exactly the same. Okay, I'm back, I'm signed in into my account, and you can see I'm on the free one here. So we're just gonna start with the free one. Now you could go in here and search as well, but we'll do that for the next one. So let's do one here with the free, just so you can see how it works. And I come in here, this one's actually created by AI, and you can go right here and download. You can see it says 750 by 1200 pixels. Now, that is not a hard and fast rule. You can use 4500 by 5400, but it has to be a certain size, and you'll see what I mean when I go here. So I'm gonna click on here, I'm gonna upload from my device here, and then find the one that I want. So I'm gonna do that autism one that I did before, that you might have seen that I posted. I created it for one of the days in February, and you can see it just posted right here. I made this 4500 by 5400. It still fits on here, and I can move it around right here. And I think there is something, yeah, so I'll move this over here. There's a live preview right here, so you can see where it's placed on the shirt, and I can size it and move it up or down wherever I want, right? And I can hit crop. Well, I want to center it, and I can hit crop like that, and it puts it on there. Now, one of the tips that I would say is I want a face on the design. I want the t-shirt facing forward, you can see some of these right here. If I use this one, for example, it's kind of sideways and there's something blocking the t-shirt. I can change the color of the t-shirt too, so you can see the white text. So there you go. You can see that's not the best way to show my t-shirt. I would want a shirt here that's forward facing, right? And there's no obstructions. And again, I can make this t-shirt color whatever color I want. Let's do this color here, darker, right? Look at that. That looks great. And I can play around with the colors. So any color that I have here in this design, because the text is white, I'm going to want to pick some of these darker colors here, but you can easily change the colors of the t-shirt very quickly. I believe this one's an AI too. I can't tell nowadays. It looks so good. But if we go back to the free one, you would just hit download the same way. This one's not a free one, but I can go and use this one as well. Let's see. You can pick recent colors that I've used recently, default colors. There is no default. These colors, which they pick here, and you can even do a custom color. So if you actually have a hex code color, you can type that in or select from the eyedropper, maybe a color that you see around here. Let's see, you can replace the design really easily. If this design didn't work, you can come back here and replace it. You can resize it, come back in here and make it bigger, make it smaller, move it up and down, right? Hit crop again when you're done, or remove this design and try something else. So this right here, add, I've never used that, so let's see what it does. Add, oh, you can add text or graphics to this too. I usually don't do that, but you can. So let's see, add a graphic. I can pick any of these graphics, maybe a, do I have anything from my Placeit? Nope. Uploads. Oh, these are some of the designs I uploaded. But yeah, you could put graphics on here if you want. Like, let's say I want that over here. And I could edit this and maybe color it. I don't know, or maybe a different. I can add more if I wanted to, I bet. Let's see. Yeah, or change it. So I could put a graphic here if I wanted to, but I usually don't. So I'm just going to delete that. I think you can, yeah, hide that there. Let's see, if you're not finding what you want, you can request that, and you can see other ones that you may like. You can also come down here and use some of these mockups if you wanted, so you can do that. And this one's tell you it is a AI generated woman, so, and what it's kind of used for. So Women's Day protests, so you can see kind of in the background if it's that. And you can favorite these if you want, and so on, and share these. Make a copy, save to. I usually just pick one. I like the wide ones more than the portrait ones. So I typically like some of these where it's a little wider, the landscape ones, because that way I can crop it a lot better. So I'll show you how I do that. So just to show you how it works, I'm gonna change the color here. I may not use this one for autism, but we're just gonna show you how it works. So I'm gonna download this right now and it's gonna save to my downloads folder, and now I can use this and crop it, and I'll show you how I do that for some of my mockups. And you can see right here, it's gonna process your mockup. You're gonna have to wait till that finishes processing, and then it's gonna have another button that says download. There it is, click here to download, boom. Okay, the next thing I wanna show you on here for t-shirts is just t-shirts by itself. So I'm just gonna do t-shirt mockups again. And you can see some of these are just by itself without anything. So t-shirts alone, is that just t-shirt? Just t-shirt, maybe that works. No, that didn't. But here's one. And I think it will, yeah. So once you pick one that has it, you can use some of these here where it's just the t-shirt, right? So I'm gonna color this here too, black. And you can remove the background. So you can actually have no background right here. And I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna use this t-shirt for one of my other mockups where I put it diagonally on the side. So I'm gonna download this one as well. Now, another thing you can do is once you have a bunch of these, you can click this button right here and it'll show you all your downloads. So you can see these downloads are the ones I just did, but I could hit view all downloads And you can see these are the ones that I did for February and in January if I scroll. And you can see I have a ton, over 33 pages. I've been doing this for a long time, of mockups, and it just saves them on here. And one of the nice things you can do with saving them, let's say you don't have to keep these on your hard drive, you can just keep them here, and if you want to use them later, they're here and you can download them again. Another thing you can do is, let's say you want this one again, you can just hit make more and it will bring it here, and you can replace the design again, and just, you don't have to hunt for this t-shirt again. You can use the same t-shirt or same mock-up again and just switch out the background. Let me show you one more thing that may happen, and that is if your design is too big, what happens? So let's go on here. I'm gonna hit replace, and I'm gonna pick one that's way too big. So you can see here, right here, this is 19 megabytes, right? So I'm gonna try and do it, and you'll see what happens. File is too big. Maximum allowed is 12 megabytes. Now, some of the times, if you're on Kiddo or you're using AI that's really big, it may not fit. So let me show you a hack. This one is built in Kiddo, but you could do this in Canva or in Affinity Designer, and that is to save a smaller version. It doesn't necessarily have to be this size, the 750 size, but it just has to be below 12 megabytes. Okay, I'm here on Kiddo. Now you can do this on Canva or Affinity Designer or wherever you make your design. Just make sure you download it at a smaller size. So one way to do that on Kiddo is when you hit download, you can hit remove background and PNG. Instead of 4,500 by 5,400, you know, you can make it 2,000 or whatever it is. You can make it 750 if you want, as long as it's smaller than 12 megabytes. So let's see if this does it. This is gonna be half the size, right? I had 4,500, now it's 2,000. So half of 19 should be 8. But let's see, I'm gonna do PNG, and it's doing it, remove background, and let's take a look at it. So yeah, so it's even smaller than 8. You can see right here, zero looks given, PNG, now 4.5 megabytes. So now I can go back in here into Placeit, replace this, go to my downloads, there it is right here, 4.5, just pick it, hit open, and you can see it replaces it. I can do here, there's the live preview over here as well, I can see it, and then I can just hit crop. And there it is. And I can pick a different color. Maybe that green is too dark for this one. I can pick a lighter green, or I could come in here and do custom and, you know, put it in green and then try some of the lighter ones here for it to work. Same thing, come over here, download, hit download. It says I'm downloading too fast, slow down. I probably clicked too fast. And then I can click here to download, and you can see it just works the same way. I don't need to download this one. But let's go into Affinity Designer. I'm gonna show you how I put together those mockups from the ones we just did in Placeit, and how you can use it on Instagram and other social media sites. So here I am in Affinity Designer. This is the file I've made for Design with Detour for February. So if you come in here, you can see what I've done. So Happy Easter, the design itself, the PNG that you saved, the shirt that I made in Placeit, and the mockup I made in Placeit. So we're gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna copy two of these here so you can see exactly what I'm doing. And we're gonna zoom in here, and we're gonna use the ones that we just did, right? So I'm gonna come in, go to my downloads page. On the side here, you can't see it, but I'm just gonna drag in the mockup that we did earlier, the autism one right here. And you can see, because this is a square, in fact, it is 1500 by 1500, and you can see it's a square, it's perfect for Instagram and for Twitter and for all the other social media sites. Square is the easy size because it fits all of those. And I can just put this design, you can see it's not a square right here. This is why I like using that one. And then I can just crop it to a square and kind of fit it right there. And I'm gonna move it to the back and remove this one. And you can make these really easy. This is just text, this is just a rectangle, this is just my logo and another text right here. And then you got it. So I would do that with yours. You can put here, you can put your logo here, whatever you want, stickers, if you're doing this in Canva. Same thing in Canva. If you did a Canva at 1500 by 1500, you could drag it into Canva as well and do the same kind of treatment. I'm just doing it in Affinity Designer. You could also do it in Inkscape, Photoshop. Just make sure that it is a square size. And we got that right there. So the next one I'm doing here is the t-shirt. Let's do that autism one right here. I'm gonna tilt it a little bit, just put it over this one. Now, I don't have to follow this exactly, but I want it to be around the same size. And one of the things that I've been doing on here is I find this design right here and I do a FX on it. So effects, got this effects right here. I'm gonna click on it. I'll show you what it is. I did this outer glow and I'm gonna do the radius of about 40 point whatever, and then 7. And then you can see how that works. I'm gonna get rid of this one right here because I don't need that one. And I'm gonna put this here. Now I'm gonna take this out and drag in the autism one that I did, the PNG that I saved, and I can just plop it right in there. Now it's gonna be bigger than I need because this is 1500 by 1500 and I did it by 4500, right? So I'm gonna have to scale this down to fit. And I typically make the background the same color as this. So if I want to make this black here, I'm on RGB hex, but I can do CMYK. And I just do that. I make that behind. And that. And then there you go. That's it. And of course, I'm going to change this to autism or whatever the day was. Right? And then now I can save these and put it on my social media. Now I'll show you my Instagram, I'll show you my YouTube, Twitter or X, and Facebook, what it looks like on those. Okay, just lastly to show you on social media how I've been doing this, you can see this one is just the design, but some of these, if I click on this latest one here, if I scroll through them, there's my mockup that we just did, and here's the other one with the t-shirt right there, same thing, right? And I've been using these mockups for a while. So if you scroll down before I did design with Detour, you can see some of these are just the designs themselves without this here. So you can see there, that's a design from Placeit, that's Placeit, that's Placeit. All of these have been Placeit. They even do like anime and kawaii stuff, including the AI stuff. So lots of different things. Just thousands and thousands of mockups. So I've used, I don't know if I've used the same one twice here. You can see they're all different people here. And on X, same thing. So you can see on here, that's a mockup. This is the same mockup right here. So just another way besides just using the default t-shirt from like Amazon or from Redbubble, you have another way that you can show things on your social media. And kind of brand your stuff and so on. And on YouTube right here, if I go to my community tab, you can see I also share these as well. So if we go through here, same thing, right? The mockups. And on Facebook here, you can see I've done the same thing. If I click in here, you can see mockups again, mockups. So really good way to use it for social media as well. Just a different way instead of using the basic mockups from other places where it's just a t-shirt. You have just another way to do these things. So there you go, that's how you use Placeit. Very simple, super simple. I use it all the time. I use it almost daily to make those mockups that you see on my social media platforms. I have a lot more videos for Placeit. I'll put a playlist right here of the ones that I've done for Placeit, and it just does so many different things. So mockups is the best thing I use it for, but there's also videos that I've done, templates and so much more. So try it out for free. It's absolutely free, just needs your email and stuff. And if you really wanna try it, I'll put a link in the description here. It is an affiliate link and I think it can get you a percentage off. So try that out as well if you're serious about it and if you're not using Placeit already. Thanks again for watching. Hopefully this video is really helpful. And as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.